It's Japan against Hungary in the bronze medal match. There was semi-final agony in Eboli for Hungary and Japan in the women's volleyball competition. Today, these two teams have a chance to bounce back from bitter defeats and take home a bronze medal. That's a good spike, probably the best so far for the Japanese. So they don't have too much height there, average height of 170. But they do have a great athleticism, determination. A lot of support, but players who are not playing, I should say, making a real racket to the side. Gabriela Rutzko coming on to serve immediately. That's what Nemec's there for. A first set point. And they have it. The block was good. So the first set won by Japan. Can they keep it going? What do Hungary have in the tank, I wonder? Disappointing there, because the door was open for Hungary. Up at the net. Best weapon, Annette Nemec, from this right-hand side, the number two position. That was really good defence from Japan. They just kept at it. Hungary knocking on the door again and again, but some really good defence. They're still in it. Set point for Japan. Was there a touch? There was. And Japan have it 25-20, moved a huge step closer to getting a medal at these Universiad. They lead by two sets to nil against Hungary. We have a mountain to climb now. Japan definitely in pole position. Steely determination about the Hungarians, as you can see. not going to let this go without a real scrap. Six set points for Hungary. Matsui must serve well. Long. Well, no. That was off the block. Japan must fight for a full set if they're going to get the bronze. Blyker, very pleased with the way her team's playing at the moment. And the blocking is getting better and better. Mehmet that time. Inouye does well. He's hoping beyond hope that there might be a comeback here. It's a very significant lead that Hungary have. More importantly, just really on a roll, dominating things. As things stand. The Mets, not quite. Goes again. Mehmet is unstoppable. She's going to push this match into a deciding set. We are at set point. What a bronze medal match we've had. It's been brilliant for the fans. Enjoying the action. There's a chance for Hungary. And they've taken it. It's going to set five. What an incredible comeback from Hungary. They really look beaten after the first two sets. Now they look like they've won it already. Got to compose themselves a little bit because still a lot of work to be done. First to 15. We'll take a bronze medal. Super match here. Down to 2 points. Off for Lila Vilam. To serve. Kish, not quite. Inouye does the job. The experience and class of Japan's best player. Under 20 international is Inouye. How important might that be? Silver medalist with the Japan under 20 team back in 2013. Will she get a bronze here, I wonder? Better blocking from Japan. In we. Great defence again. It's out. It's out. It's a point for Japan. Despite the best efforts of Frazina Tott, who has defended brilliantly, Japan have the point and they're two away from a victory, a famous victory. My word, it'd be a hard-fought one. What an advert for women's volleyball at the Universiade. Bronze medal match. It's ebbed and flowed. Japan have lost big lead. Hungary came back like a train. Oh, that's brilliant blocking. Fantastic blocking from Japan. Just when Nemeth was winding up for another big spike. And suddenly, it's match point for Japan. You have to say, a fantastic comeback in the deciding set. It's match point. One is saved. Sofia Gimes has been brilliant tonight. Not as brilliant as this player, Annette Nemeth, one of the stars of this competition, but she might go home without a medal. Great defence again. The spike is good, Japan have it! And what an amazing bronze medal match we have. Hungary denied a first ever medal in the Universiade. A dramatic win in the fifth set, 15-10 for Japan, and they go home with the bronze. Top level women's volleyball action ends with hosts versus defending champions battling it out for Universiade gold. Italy carry the hopes of the host nation. Russia have an untouchable record in this event in recent years and won't be overawed at an Eboli Arena. Good. Back to 15-all. Beatrice Berti. Shortest player on this Italian team. Lazareva, which is the second top point scorer in this competition, 115 points ahead of tonight's match. 93 successful spikes. Hanging on, because they can't afford to lose this point off. What does that serve? And they don't. Looking good for them. Off the antenna, and Russia have the first set, 25-21. A mistake. It's very wayward, and a free point for Italy. Time too much on the spike from Anna Lazareva. Another one off the Milani serve. This is the best period so far for the Italians. Lazareva again. Huge pass from Nicoletti, and the point was won. That's good enough for a set point. Nicoletti's spike is big enough. And it's one set all. And we have a real match on our hands here in this gold medal clash between Italy and Russia. One set apiece. My word, what a point. And the Italians are on their feet at the Palasella in Emily. They love that. Good for a good big serve now. Yes, it's gone the right way for Italy. Brilliant blocking. And they have a set point. There was tension in the air there. Italy have a set point. Anna Nicoletti, their top scorer, serves again. Look at the big one. It's out, just out. My word, that was close. A few centimetres in it. Smirnova dancing for joy in front of me. Drama in Eboli. It's another point for the Russians. Suddenly they have set point. It's a set point for Russia. Absolutely vital point, this one. Lazareva, they're going to win the point. There's no stopping the spiker. Anna Lazareva has done that all week long. And Russia have the third set. And what a set it was. Relief for the Italians. Roccalo doing the job. Off to be replaced by her captain, Carlotta Cambi. This is a point in the game where the Italians need all the guile and experience of Cambi. And another one for Italy, they're back in it. Really good determination from the hosts. Good blocking from Russia. Point one over. Now it is, and that's an important one. Stopping that mini comeback on the hosts. 21-17 now. Zubareva. Olga Zubareva to serve on this rotation. And it's... Oh, it's in! It's landed on the wrong side of the line as far as the Italians are concerned. And it's an ace. Zubareva did exactly the right thing. Came on for the serve. She's hit an ace, and what an important one it was. It's a 5-point lead again. It's desperately disappointing for the Italians. Of the last 15 points have gone Russia's way. Oh, and it's another good one for Russia. Excellent blocking. And this is a real gap now, 6 points. You can feel the tension around the arena here in Eboli. What do Italy have left in the tank? It's going to be a match point after another huge spike from Vorobieva. Match point for Russia. There are some heads in hands around this arena. The Italians feeling that might be the end of the road for them. Match point. Really good blocking from the Russians. And again, and that's it. Russia have the gold medal. They're on the court. The celebrations have started. It's desperately disappointing for the hosts. They scrapped and battled and came back to win the second set. Russia have the gold. Italy have a silver. It's a 3-1 win with a 25-18 victory in that last set. I hope you've enjoyed the volleyball. It's a victory for Russia, 3-1. And for the fourth time in a row, Russia are volleyball champions, women's volleyball champions at the Summer Universiade. Russia with the gold.